Good afternoon, Penndale. Today is June 10th, and after a great year of production, our final Penndale TV broadcast. I'm Aparna Mukherjee.
And I'm Maddie Heilweil. Although it's bittersweet to be our last show, I promise we're going out with a bang. Our top story this week is congratulations to the student government winners for next year. President Anissa Gardizi, Vice President Krisha Patel, Treasurer Olivia Dyer, Secretary Claire Dettner, 9th grade Senators Sophia McKee and Caitlin Van Dane, 8th grade Senators Aiden Sullivan and Billy Wang, Media Coordinators Sarah Marshall and James Murphy, and E3 Representative Liaison Brianne Scott.
Also, congratulations to the winners of the National Junior Honor Society election for next year. The results are as follows. For President, we have Reed Dettner, Siobhan Lestana is serving as Vice President, Sung Cheng is Secretary, Pollock Shah is Treasurer, Lauren Matalevich is Historian, and Catherine Schlegel is our Service Coordinator. Once again, congratulations to all of our National Junior Honor Society election winners.
Last week, when we entered the building, we were all greeted with a pleasant surprise. Let's go to Anissa with more on that story.
Hi, I'm Anissa Gardivi from Penndale Television, and here with me today, I have Morgan Nato and Kata Mint. Now, Morgan, can you tell us a little bit about the surprise students received on their lockers when they walked into school last week?
It was just all a random act of kindness, and Rachel Scott, she helped influence me be the chain reaction in Penndale.
That's great. Kate, how long did it take you guys to do this?
It took a really long time, like 5 months, so.
That's a long time. Morgan, what inspired you guys?
Rachel helped inspire this because she was the chain reaction in her school of random act of kindness, and so I would like to follow in her footsteps.
Thank you guys for being the chain reaction in our school. Were you surprised at all the attention your act got?
Yeah, because it left the school, and we weren't expecting that at all. We thought it was just gonna be something nice in the school, and it kind of got out, and we didn't expect that, so.
That shows you how far a little act can go. I'm Anissa Gardizi from Penndale Television. Back to you.
Of course, the biggest event that takes place in the Philadelphia Convention Center is the auto show. But if you missed that, members of North Penn High School's Auto Club organized their own auto show everyone could watch during various lunch periods. Students participating entered their cars into different categories, with the winners announced later on in the week. The North Penn Model A Ford Club also brought a variety of classic cars to the event. This is a yearly event that many will be able to enjoy as they enter North Penn in the next few years. Who knows? Maybe Mr. Thatcher's 1975 station wagon can win next year.
Here's a sports update from Pawling's Peoples.
Thanks. Now joining me is head coach of the undefeated 8th grade softball team, Mr. Matt Singer. How many games did your team play this season?
Well, it was supposed to be a 12-game schedule. We had one that was canceled, two that were canceled, excuse me, one that they didn't have enough girls. We went 9-0.
So how did your team improve along those 9 games?
Our fielding got better. Our pitching, we were a good pitching and hitting team to start with, but toward the end of the season, we really came through with the hitting. The fielding. We fielded very well.
So how did this compare to last year's team?
Well, actually, I had the same set of girls last year, 7th graders. Mr. DeCiro and I just flipped teams, so I got to coach them. They were undefeated last year also, and we have a total team concept, which really worked out well for us.
So what do you expect out of this team next year when they're 9th graders?
Wow. I expect a couple of the girls will probably play either JV or varsity. I expect Mr. Bruner to have a really strong team with the girls that are left to play 9th grade. And I believe that they will be very successful as 9th graders also.
Do you have any advice for the girls over the summer in preparation for next school year's team?
Train. Run, lift, or do body weight push-ups and chin-ups and everything. Everything's about what you do off the field now. And then, of course, play softball and train that way also.
And one last question. What do you like to do when you're not coaching the team or being a health and gym teacher?
I work out as much as possible. I train my own kids. I spend time with my wife and kids as much as possible. We like to go to the beach and stuff like that.
Sounds like a lot of fun. Now joining me are Jess and Caroline. What positions did you guys play for the team?
I played played shortstop and outfield.
Shortstop and pitcher.
So you both played shortstop. Who played shortstop the most out of the two of you?
I don't know. It just kind of went on between about three people.
So what do you guys think your team improved on most throughout the season?
I think we really improved on our fielding. We got a lot better.
And what are your expectations for next year's season?
I think we'll be an even stronger team than we were this year.
All right, that's all. You guys have a great summer. I'm Andrew Pauling, and we'll send it back to you at the desk.
Danny, who after this show is hanging up his press hat for Penndale TV, interviewed a fellow retiree this week.
Thanks. I'm Dan Kirkpatrick here with the last interview for Penndale TV's television for this year. Well, it's the end of the school year, and everyone's sad about leaving. Not. Sadly, we have some teachers that are retiring this year, and I'd first like to go over to Mr. Solly. So, Mr. Solly, you're retiring this year, correct?
Correct.
How many years have you been teaching here at Penndale?
36.
36 years. Wow. What are your highlights of teaching here?
There are so many, I really don't know what to say. A lot of cool people, a lot of nice people here, a lot of good people. I'd say every year has had its highlights. Far more good than bad.
Yeah, I agree. I've been here for three and it's been good. Any particular events in, you know, Blue and White Day or Spirit Day, something that you personally enjoyed?
I enjoyed helping out with some of the concerts and things that we did here. Accompanying for concerts and stuff.
That's good, that's good. Yep. What do you think you're going to miss most?
The people. Staff. Interaction with the kids, yeah, the staff, the people the most.
I'm going to miss it too when I leave. Yep. Now, there are still a lot of things that you're going to miss, but is there anything that you're not going to miss so much? You know, what's the least that you're going to miss?
Not going to miss. Some of the paperwork, some of that kind of stuff I won't miss. But there's a lot more that I will miss than won't miss.
I'm sure that we all don't like paperwork. And finally, do you have any plans after teaching when you leave Penndale? Anything afterwards that you have planning on doing?
Well, first I'm going to get up in the morning when I feel like it, instead of at 5:30. And no immediate plans, maybe some traveling, and then maybe get into some musical things when I'm, you know, yeah, I'm done all that. Yeah.
Yep, Solly. Traveling, music, and getting up early, they all sound good, trust me. Thanks again for your time here, Mr. Solly. Thanks. For Penndale TV, I'm Dan Kirkpatrick, and we're going to send it back over to you.
It's time for Twitter Mania.
Today's Twitter question is, what are your summer plans?
I'll be spending my summer here at Penndale, working on the schedules, making sure the building is ready for the staff and the students coming back next school year.
I'll be down at the shore and hopefully just sitting at my house.
I'm going to go visit the dill pickle factory.
I'm not doing anything.
I'm going to go to the beach, and I might go to Virginia.
I don't have any plans.
I'm going to Europe.
To go to the beach and have a good vacation.
Plans are to play hockey.
To hang out with my friends.
I work at the local soup kitchens, give out food and clothing to the needy.
I'm going to be in the North Penn marching nights.
I'm going to relax.
I tan, I swim, I eat, I watch TV.
Going to the beach and hang out with my friends.
I'm going to the beach and hanging out with my friends.
I'm going to be like playing outside with a lot of my friends, doing football, soccer, all that.
I'm going to be reading.
Playing basketball.
Sleeping.
I'm going to go to the pool.
I'm going to play soccer.
I'm going to Wildwood, New Jersey.
I'm going to Niagara Falls.
I'm chilling at Mr. Thatcher's house. What up, dog?
Hold on, guys. It's the moment we've all been waiting for. The series finale of Boo Boo's Crusade.
Oh, fiddlesticks! I was just at the good part!
Let's go!
I wonder who's at the door. Oh, fiddlesticks, boo-boo! It's your mom! Let's celebrate! But first, we need some guests. Pope Francis! Confucius Wang! Hey, handsome gentlemen. Hey, check out Charlie! What's up? Hey, Stormtrooper! Hey, Tinky Winky! Oh, wait! I think we're missing somebody. Look, Boo Boo, it's Justin Bieber.
Escape from Alcatraz prison, I am here. I come with a bat star, boat cape, and I would disappear. Just like paper, update. Boo Boo's crusade is finished. An evil dark fate has been diminished. Boo Boo's crusade is over. It happened just today.
And now, Vegas Vona for his last broadcast of 2014. Take it away, Vegas.
Hello, Penndale! All right, E3 teachers, get those boxes of tissues ready, because unfortunately we come to that time of the year where this is the absolute last Vegas Vona show for the year. So at that, I'd like to thank everybody for the hustle and the bustle, the commotion, the all kinds of things. I am overtaken by the pandemonium in the hallways. So I'd like to thank you for everything. For that, have a good summer. Vegas Vona out. Stop it. Really? You can't kill Vegas Vona on the last episode? Really? For Penndale TV and Vegas Vona.
I'm not sure about this weather pattern we're in. Let's go to our weather specialist on location to see what this week's and this summer's weather will look like.
Outside Penndale here for our last broadcast. Right now it's about 70 and the fog's finally clearing up. Pretty bad this morning. The rest of the week looks pretty good. It's going to get sunny as the week goes on. It's going to get warmer, and by Friday it'll be in the low 80s. Let's go to Julie for the rest of the summer forecast. See what she has to say.
Hey Penndale, what's up? So June, it's going to be from like 79, that's the average high for here, go down to 60. In July, it's going to be 84, go down to 64, usually. In August, it's 82 to 62. September, it's 75 to 53. We get out June 18th, and we come back around September 2nd. That's what I said. So we have 75 days of summer, so make it the best summer you have. Hashtag bundle up. Back to you at the desk.
And that's all we have for you today to wrap up 2014. Thanks for making our year as a team so enjoyable.
And at the end of our show, we will be airing two very special broadcasts with picture-perfect moments from this year. The first is a collection of Boo Boo's birthday and all who attended. The second is our end of the year slideshow.
Thanks for sticking with us through 2014. It's been a blast.
Signing off for Penndale Television for the last time, I'm Maddie Heilweil.
And I'm Aparna Mukherjee. Have a great summer, everyone.
Come on, Heller.
Come here, Heller.
Come on.
Come on, Heller.
You got a friend in me.
You got a friend in me. When the road looks
rough ahead, and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed. You just remember what your old pal said, boy, you've got a friend in me. Yeah, you've got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. If you got troubles, I got them too. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. If we stick together, we can see it through. Cause you got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me. Might be a little bit smarter than I am.
Bigger and stronger too,
baby.
But none of them will ever love you the way I do. It's me and you, boy.
And as the years go by,
our friendship will never die.
You're gonna see it's our destiny. You got a friend in me.
You got a friend in me.
Yeah, you got a friend.